Hi book besties, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Ellie, for anyone who doesn't know me, and long time no see. I don't really have much of an excuse except that I am kind of a perfectionist and it's really hard for me to make content that I'm proud of, and so I kept filming things throughout the whole month of October and most of November and then hating it and then not wanting to film anymore or just not wanting to edit it. So yeah, I'm trying to get over that and just film for the fun of it, but I'm definitely still a perfectionist at heart, so bear with me. So that's why I kind of went MIA for most of October and then November, and then I was planning on filming something fun in November, but then my boyfriend broke up with me and my mental health just took a pretty big dive, and I don't really want to cry on camera, so I'm not going to talk about it except to say that if any of you guys are struggling with heartbreak or just mental health issues, just please reach out to somebody, because I'm a firm believer that everything happens for a reason and things will get better, and I definitely believe that things will get better for me, so they will get better for you as well. That's all I'm really going to say on that. But I figured, in the spirit of escaping and kind of making myself feel better and heal and recover faster, I would come visit my dad and my sister. So I'm in their house right now. That's why my background looks a little bit different. And then usually my other form of escapism and healing is books. So I figured, let's just get back into reading and doing something that I love, and hopefully that will help me feel better. So that is what we're gonna do today. If you couldn't already tell by the title of the video, we are going to be reading, you guessed it, A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas. This book has a cult following on Bookstagram and BookTube and all book places, and I'm really hoping I get to join the cult, because I don't know what she puts in these books, but it must be crack because everybody loves them. So I'm really hoping I love them too. I've heard that they are mostly like fantasy books. I usually don't read fantasy just because I feel like I usually prefer watching it. Like, I love watching Game of Thrones and stuff like that, but it's hard for me to read fantasy unless the writing is really good, because it's hard to get into the world and the characters unless the writing is good. So I'm hoping that's the case with this book, but I also heard that there's some romance in here, and this first book in particular is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. I feel like I could use a little bit of romance in my life right now, and you know what? If a real man can't do it, a fictional man certainly can, so. I'm here in my dad's house for the next 3 days, including today, and my sister's in school, so I have nothing else to do. So I figured I'm just gonna go to Barnes & Noble and read all day and have a blast. With my sister. We ended up watching Beauty and the Beast, the live action version, and suffice it to say, things got a little bit out of hand. Beef ragu, cheese souffle, pie and pudding, all fromage. We'll prepare myself with flair of culinary. I love this part. But I am back on track today, and I figured I'm gonna keep reading A Court of Thorns and Roses. I really didn't get that far at all, probably like 50 pages. So I'm gonna speed read through this, hopefully. Hopefully I can finish it today before she gets back from school. And then maybe I can go get the second book today. we'll see. But yeah. It's been a minute. I basically haven't really checked in with you guys since I was at my dad's house, which was early December, and it is now December 31st. I really thought I was gonna be better about vlogging, reading this series, but a lot of stuff happened since then. Basically, as you all know, my life kind of took a turn for the worse. And I decided that for the sake of my own mental health, it would be way better to be closer to family. So I decided rather spontaneously to move back to California, and I got a travel nursing position there. And yeah, I have all my stuff packed up. My apartment is basically empty, and I have another week here before my flight. So I'm currently sleeping on an air mattress in my empty apartment, and yeah, so that kind of got in the way of vlogging and all this stuff, but I'm gonna catch up now if I can. Basically, I finished A Court of Thorns and Roses, or Acotar. I absolutely loved this book, and I could definitely see the Beauty and the Beast elements in it, in the story and the plot line, which I loved because Beauty and the Beast is one of my favorite Disney princess tales. But yeah, I really only have good things to say about this, especially I would say in the last like third of the book when she's under the mountain. that was so good. There was so much action and drama. I really felt like I was in those moments with Feyre as she was struggling to get through all these trials that Amarantha was putting her through. I have no words. I love this book. It was so good. And now I am currently reading A Court of Mist and Fury. Most people that I've talked to say that this one is their favorite. I am most of the way through it. I think I only have like a couple hundred pages left. And I can see why. I can see why this is people's favorite. Ooh. Now, don't get me wrong. I loved Tamlin in this first book, and I was really, really rooting for him for the vast majority of the book, pretty much the whole book. But even when Rhys was being a total, you know what, I was still really loving him. Tell me why. I guess I just have a thing for bad boys, but he was really, And now that I'm reading more about him and Feyre in A Court of Mist and Fury, Tamlin who? That is all I have to say, because Rhys, baby? That man could run me over with a truck any day. I'm also just gonna take a moment to talk about the banter in this book. As good as the dialogue was in A Court of Thorns and Roses, the dialogue in A Court of Mist and Fury, I have no words. It's just so good. The lines in here, I just wanna get them tattooed on my soul. I'm obsessed, if you couldn't tell. So I'm really excited to finish this one up tonight. Now, I did kind of spoil it for myself. I've watched a lot of TikToks on this book series, and I kind of already knew that Feyre ends up with Rhys. So that was less of a surprise for me going into this second book. I also know that one of the spicy scenes is one of the 50 something chapters. I don't know which one, but I know it's in the 50s somewhere, and I'm on chapter 49. So I actually just finished the share the bed scene where her and Rhys have to share a bed for the night, and can we all have a moment of silence for that, because I think I stopped breathing. So I don't even know how I'm gonna survive the spicy scene in this book, But I think it's going to be very entertaining for you, so I'm going to film my reaction. That is really the plan for tonight, is finishing this book. It is a Saturday night. It is New Year's Eve. And I have no plans. So I'm going to try and hold it together, and we're just going to read, and hopefully I can hold it together long enough to make it to midnight. Oh my God. She just said, "I want you to know that I am broken and healing, but every piece of my heart belongs to you, and I'm honored, honored to be your mate." Oh my God, this is painfully cute. I can't do this right now. My heart can't handle this right now. I'm falling in love with a fictional man. What's wrong with me? Okay, just focus, focus. Oh, things are getting heated. Are they about to do it on this table? With paint everywhere? That sounds so messy, but also, yes, please. Oh, it's getting hard to breathe. Oh. Helped her out first before being helped, if that makes sense. I'm gonna try and keep this PG, but yeah, I respect that, because I feel like in most romance books they just get right to the right to that part, but he actually helped her out first. Beautiful. What a beautiful thing. That was so good. Oh no, okay, the only thing is, the whole roaring thing, I don't know. I feel like I can't hear that sound in my head. Like, I see these TikToks that make fun of it all the time, of like, he roared as he, and I agree. I'm like, what is that? If a man roared during that situation, I would be real confused. So that's the but like, he is a different species, so maybe it makes sense. I don't know. But yeah, that's the only part that I was like, not my favorite. Otherwise, it was such a good scene. It was such a good mix between like tender and loving and like spicy. I think it's like 11 or something like that, so I'm gonna pause where I'm at and get dressed and get ready to ring in the new year by myself. And yeah, then we'll keep reading. Happy New Year, everybody. It is officially 2023. I knew it was gonna hit me, but I really thought I could hold it together. I don't really know what's making me so upset, honestly. I guess it's just because it's the second year that I'm spending New Year's Eve at home alone in my apartment by myself. And I guess it's just really hard to feel lonely sometimes. Long story short, I moved to Chicago all by myself for work, and
It was a really hard adjustment because I didn't have any family here or any friends. And basically for the whole first year that I was here, I was pretty darn lonely because as an introvert, it is really hard for me to make friends. I guess it's just hard to feel like I didn't really make any progress this year. And like I'm still alone and I'm still lonely. And I don't know, knowing that other people are out there celebrating with friends and family, and I'm here in my apartment by myself. I do have my cats, technically, so I can't complain. But yeah, it's a low point for sure. Anyway, enough of that wallowing in self-pity. I think I am going to probably call my mom, call my dad, maybe cry a little bit more, and then I'm gonna get cozy and maybe I'll watch something just to distract myself for a little bit before I keep reading. But Happy New Year, everybody. Morning. So, I finished A Court of Mist and Fury last night. I don't even know where to start with this book. It was so good. So good. I thought A Court of Thorns and Roses was good. No. A Court of Mist and Fury is potentially officially my new favorite book. And that's saying a lot. It had a little bit of romance, a little bit of political intrigue, a little bit of action and fantasy, and it was so beautiful. Again, the writing was so well done. I don't think I was bored at any point, and that's kind of amazing considering it's like a 700 page book. Well, 620, something like that. It's a long book, and the fact that it kept me intrigued throughout all those 600 pages is impressive. I think, again, just the love between Feyre and Rhys. I want that for myself. But it's okay. New year, new me, new opportunities. That's where my mind has to be in order for me to keep it together. Anyway, I am a Faceend. That's their couple name, right? I've seen it on Instagram, on TikTok and stuff. It's Faceend, like Feyre and Reason. Is it Reason or Ryson? I'm gonna go with Reason because personally, I think that sounds way better. Like, I'm not gonna call him Rice. I mean, okay, I guess that sounds cute too, but I'm personally more of a Reese fan, so nobody kill me, but I'm gonna say Reese. I am a Faceend stan for life. These two are everything. And the last 10 chapters, 10-ish, I'd say 10 chapters of this book. What? Like, I don't even know where to begin. I kind of suspected that Nesta was gonna be Faye based on some of the things I saw on TikTok. That's kind of where I thought this was heading. I just didn't realize that both Elaine and Nesta were gonna be turned, and I didn't realize that it was gonna be in the way that it happened. And I didn't know that Lucien was Elaine's mate. Just the whole last 10 chapters of this book, I was like, what is happening? I need to start the next book immediately. So it is A Court of Wings and Ruin. It is another thick one. I think she's 700 pages, and the big book fear is real, but we got through one big book, so I think I can get through another one. I think this one, from what I've heard, is another one of people's favorites, but it's more political, and it's about the war that I think is coming. I don't know, like, if the whole thing is about the war or how, like, what's gonna happen, but I think this one is a little bit more serious than the other two that I've read so far. So we'll see what happens. Oh,
Oh my god. See, this is why I can never read properly, because this always happens. Literally every time I try to read, one of them has to be on top of me. Ma'am, personal space, please. Personal space. Help.
Okay, it's a few hours later now. I haven't gotten that far into the book just because I've been doing things for work in between, but I'm at the part where Feyre finally comes back to Rhys and the Night Court after being at the Spring Court and like spying on them for months, weeks, I don't know. And it's... I am unwell. These two are so cute and it's so painful to read because I want that so bad. I think I also forgot to mention, but I hate Tamlin with my whole being and my whole soul. All I feel for him is pure unadulterated rage and hatred. He's dead to me. I hate him. I hate him. Also, if you can see this little patch right here, don't mind that. That's just a little pimple patch because your girl is getting some stress breakouts. It's great. Anyway, I'm gonna keep reading and I'll update you a little bit later.
Why am I literally about to cry right now? What is wrong with me? Rhys just said, I missed you every second, every breath, not just this, but talking to you, laughing with you. I missed having you in my bed, but missed having you as my friend even more. To have a man that says they want you for not just like your body or like what you can do for them, but for you being their friend and like knowing them really well and being their partner. I swear, men written by women are a whole other breed, and I can't take this right now. I'm struggling so hard. Oh my god, I need a hug and I need cuddles. Yes, please, I need cuddles. Thank you. I needed cuddles.
Hi, guys. So it's been a few days. The last you will have seen of me, I was packing up my stuff and leaving my apartment in Chicago. And after that, I got on a flight. I came all the way here to San Diego. And yeah, I am starting my life here. I feel like I'm already feeling better. It's been really nice being surrounded by family and people that love me. I feel like I'm already kind of starting to heal little by little. So, I feel very blessed and happy to be here. Yeah, it's going to be a process and a journey, but we're going to take it one day at a time. Anyway, that is beside the point. In those few days, I did end up finishing A Court of Wings and Ruin. And you guys, this book, ugh, it was so good. I almost want to say that I liked it more than A Court of Mist and Fury. I really thought that I was going to be bored by this book because everybody said it was about the war, and so I was picturing it being really dull and tedious to read. Nothing could have been further from the truth. It was so interesting, so gripping. I feel like I wasn't bored at any point in this book. These characters honestly are amazing, and the plot line of this book especially, it had a little bit more political intrigue, slightly less romance, I would say, but still a good dose in there. And again, I don't think that it was really all that spicy in my mind. I think people tend to make it seem like this series is all about spicy scenes and that it's a spicy series. I would disagree. I think it's predominantly about the characters and their stories instead of spice, which I like and I enjoy. I do enjoy a little sprinkle of spice here and there, but it's definitely not spice centered. Anyway, I think that's all I really have to say for now. I mean, I could say so much more about these books because they're really stealing my heart in so many ways, but I'm going to try and leave the long commentary for the end if I can. And I'm just going to go ahead and start the next book, which is A Court of Frost and Starlight. So, Acafoss. And this one is a little itty-bitty novella. It is so much smaller than all the other books by comparison. This one I think is only 250 pages, and I was, 230. And I was looking at the font size as well. The font size is way bigger than the other books, so I think it should read pretty quickly. I'm hoping I can finish it tonight, because like I said, I do have work tomorrow night and the night after. And I do really want to start and finish the last book. For now, I'm just going to read this beautiful thing, and I will check in with you guys later. Actually ended up finishing the acotar series. I decided to finish it off camera just because I have way too much footage at this point and this video is getting way too long, so I just decided I'm just gonna skip right ahead to the review part and talk about all the books. I'm not really gonna talk about the first three because I've basically talked about them already and you already know my thoughts on these. They're 5 stars, all of them. They're amazing. I love them. So yeah, that's all I'm gonna say on these. So we left off with me starting A Court of Frost and Starlight, and I did end up finishing it. This is the little baby novella of the group. I have mixed feelings on this one. This one was probably my least favorite. Here's my thing. So the majority of the book is the Night Court basically celebrating winter solstice, and it's all the characters buying each other gifts, celebrating. It's cute. It's, you know, whimsical. It's kind of like a fun break from all the action of the previous three books. And coming off of A Court of Wings and Ruin, I do understand why Sarah J. Maas felt the need to write this book, just because she wanted to tie up some loose ends and kind of give certain characters an ending, almost. Not an ending, but some closure after the war, basically. And this was that book. This was like the closure after the war book. And so it wasn't that interesting, I guess you could say. It was fluffy. And although I do love a good fluffy book, this one just, it struck a low chord for me. I got through it. It's not that long, so it's not a huge investment of time, but it also wasn't riveting either, especially coming off of Acawar. This one was just meh. It was pretty bland. 3 stars for this one. And then we come to A Court of Silver Flames, and I really thought that this one was going to be my favorite one because Nesta and Cassian are probably my two favorite characters. I really feel like Nesta is the misunderstood villain of this series, and she really did get under my skin a few times in this book and in the other books, and so I was really looking forward to understanding her character more in this book as well as Cassian's, and I wasn't necessarily disappointed. I think the only problem I had with this book was that it was really long. It was 750 pages, and honestly the first 300 were pretty repetitive. I would say probably at part 3 or maybe halfway into part 2, things started to pick up and it started to feel more reminiscent of Acawar. Again, do I understand why the first 300 pages are in there? Yes,
But I also wonder if it could have been a little bit more synthesized so that it wasn't 300 pages of her going up and down the stairs of the House of Wind and struggling with things and, you know. So for that reason, I feel like I gave it a 4 out of 5 just because it was not super riveting to start out with. Again, I understand why, and I understand the need to have her go through that emotional kind of catharsis, but it was a little tricky to read. The other reason I'd say I'd give it a 4 out of 5 is just because I didn't love the ending. Spoiler alert, but basically Nesta gives up all of her powers at the end, or almost all of her powers. Something is left, but it's a trickle of what she used to have. I understand, again, why she had to do that, and I think it was an important moment for her to give them up for Feyre, because Feyre gave up so much for her and Elaine in the beginning of the books. But it was just frustrating, because she had this power that she had to learn how to deal with and cope with, and she was finally kind of coming into her own and understanding who she is and learning how to be this new powerful entity, and then she just wasn't that powerful entity anymore. And it was kind of a letdown. I'm curious to see what is left in future books. I know this isn't the last book, and I'm really excited to read the next books that she comes out with. From my research, apparently she's going to be writing 2 more novellas and 2 more books, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm really excited to read those. So anyway, point is, this one gets 4 out of 5. I still really, really loved it. There were just a couple of things that put me off a little. I will also say this was definitely the spiciest book out of all of them, and I expected that, but I don't think I expected how spicy it was going to be. It was like every other chapter. I'm not every other chapter, but it was a lot more than the other books. Fair warning for anybody out there who doesn't like spice, this may not be the book for you. Whew. Okay, so that being said, I have officially finished the acotar series. I would say as a whole, this series is 5 stars for me. I loved the action, the adventure, the political intrigue, the romance. I mean, it had a little bit of everything, and these characters, they just started to feel like family, I think. And with everything going on in my life over the past couple of months, I needed it. I needed a break and an escape, and these books gave me that. So I will be forever grateful to Sarah J. Maas for writing them and for giving me that escape and making my life a little bit happier the past couple months. So anyway, we are finally officially done with this vlog. I know it has been literally a couple months in the making, and I'm so sorry about that. It's probably gonna be a long one because there's just a lot that went down in my life over the past couple months. But thank you guys for watching and for coming along with me on this interesting journey. And thank you to Sarah J. Maas for helping me get through it in some small way. I know, her as a person, maybe not the best, but her as an author, I'm obsessed. So these books will forever hold a special place in my heart, and I 1000% recommend them to anybody out there. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts about these books. I want to know what court you think you'd be a part of. I want to know what sister is your favorite, what bat boy is your favorite. I want to know everything, so leave me comments down below. We can have a discussion about it, because like I said, these books are my new obsession. And if you hate these books, I totally get it, but please don't rat on me or anybody else that loves them. Let's not take away anybody's happiness and joy in reading by shaming them for reading a certain book, okay? Let's not do that. Let's keep this community positive. I only want to hear positive things. Let's be kind to one another, okay? All right. Anyway, so that being said, I think we are finally done with this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know it was a long one, and I know it was random and kind of personal too, but I hope that it helped anybody who's been feeling lonely out there feel a little bit less alone. And just know that I'm always here for you if you need help, if you need somebody to talk to. I will be here for you at the very least, so feel free to reach out. I will link all my social medias down below in case you want to follow me. It would mean the world. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, I guess I'll see you in the next video. Bye!
for you.